Big Beautiful Babies, it's Megan Hanges, and you are watching Life Size Beauty. Hello, it's been a minute. I am making this video after very popular demand, and this is a question that I get every day, all day. What is your skincare routine? You all have been noticing the flawlessness. I actually think most of you have been noticing that I do a lot of videos, if not all of my videos, without any makeup on. And there are a few reasons for that. Number one, I don't have the time when I'm making daily videos to be putting on a bunch of makeup. For instance, right now I'm not wearing any makeup. I need like to do one of those fancy beauty guru, like where they wipe a thing over their face to prove it, but I'm not wearing any makeup. I haven't washed my face or moisturized yet, so this is just early morning wake up Tanjas. Now I know things like filters and lighting and angles and all of that magic can make your face look different, can make your skin look better. I'm sure there are a lot of people on this site that put on makeup and then say that they're not wearing makeup because they are giving into the societal pressure to always be perfect all of the time. Listen, it's hard, okay? When people expect you to look a certain way, and we've seen how much negativity people get when they show their actual skin, there's a lot of pressure, so I get it. So first things first, I don't have perfect skin, okay? There's unevenness, there's redness, I have breakouts, I get circles under my eyes, I have these lines that I've had for forever because I like laughing, okay? I like feeling joy. And I'm 32, so as I'm getting older, I'm definitely noticing a difference in my skin. And so like the rest of the world, I'm just sitting here trying to figure out, okay, what the fuck do you want from me? What, you're dry today? All of a sudden we have dry skin. Oh, okay, now I'm too oily and shiny on camera. Okay, where did that come from? Like, it's a constant battle to figure out what's going on. I generally say that I have combination skin on the side of dry just because I am a bitch that loves moisture. I love moisture. Let me be glowy and oily looking. I do not care. I want to look like a goddamn angel. I want to look like the lights of heaven are shining down on me. Baby Jesus himself has said, yes, this one. But I swear to you, I did not start getting clearer skin until college. And I don't know what it was because they sit here and they say diet and drink water. Girl, I live off of Diet Coke. And even when I say this, I know people are going to say, well, when you start eating healthy, your skin is just cleansing itself. It's just, you know, everything's coming through. And I've never gone past that stage because generally once I start breaking out, I'm like, ooh, it's time to get another Big Mac. Before you go in the comments, God, just take a goddamn joke. I mean, it's a half joke because listen, I will sit down and eat some chicken nuggets any day of the week. I will just say that I haven't noticed as much of a difference with diet on my skin. Now, this will be an ongoing series because I'm obsessed with skincare stuff. I'm trying new stuff all of the time, and I haven't had a lot of bad interactions with any products. So it's very rare that something breaks me out. I guess my skin is not as sensitive as I thought it was. Or maybe it just likes chemicals, which possible. So I'm gonna put on my 40 millimeter and show you a little bit of a close-up of my skin. This is how my skin looks without makeup. I haven't cleansed or moisturized or done anything today, so this is just as natural as it gets. Now, I don't really deal with a lot of breakouts. That kind of happens about once a month. All of a sudden, I'm like, oh, why am I breaking out? All of a sudden, oh, because my ovaries hate me. At 32 years old, I'm basically doing everything I can to just keep it super moisturized and make sure that I'm using products that make it feel soft and good. And taking care of my skin and figuring out a routine that works for me has really become a huge part of my self-care because I just feel good. Like, it feels luxurious. It feels like I'm treating myself whenever I get a new moisturizer or a new mask or, oh my God, a new scrub. I love a scrub. It's like a fun little science experiment, and I won't know how it turns out until I'm in my 60s and 70s, if I make it that far. So I figured today that I would show you some of my favorite products that I've been using lately. So something that I have to admit is that even though I love skincare, with all the stuff that I'm doing, I can get a little lazy when it comes to how many steps I wanna take. So in my perfect skincare routine, I am cleansing, I am using a serum, I am at least twice a week using an exfoliator, I'm moisturizing, and oh my God, do I love an overnight mask. Overnight masks are so slept on. I didn't even mean for that to be a pun. That's great. But day to day, I will show you the two products that I use that are just the quickest and I'm completely out of them. So day to day, when I get up and I have to work on videos and I just need to clean my skin real quick and get a little moisture in there. And again, I don't even know if this is the right way to use these products, but they work for me. I've been really enjoying this Pixi Skin Treats Glow Tonic. So this is meant to be a toner. It has glycolic acid in it. Gently exfoliates to remove dead skin cells, revealing healthy, glowing skin. This is one of those products that I didn't have, like, I didn't put it on and have some grand revelation of, oh my God, this is life-changing, but I kept using it. So usually I'll just put this on a cotton pad in the morning, wipe it all over my face, and I honestly kind of use this as the cleanser for the day. And that's probably not the way that I'm supposed to be using, but it's refreshing and it doesn't dry my skin out too much. And I feel like I've kind of gotten all of the gunk and dirt off my face. When I look at that little cotton pad in the morning, I'm like, ooh, you did good work. And then I followed up with this Makeup Raw Sauce Acer Maple Water. I bought this at a Sephora back in the day, and I was pulled in by the packaging. I just thought it was so pretty. Didn't know how the hell to use it, didn't know how the hell to implement it, and kind of started using it as like a serum slash moisturizer. So in the morning, use this to clean off my face, and then I will put this on and my face feels glowing, it feels good, it feels soft. Then to exfoliate. So I try to exfoliate probably twice a week. Sometimes I forget, or sometimes I do more than that. It kind of depends on how my face is feeling and if it's feeling super dry and I need to slough off all that skin. And so a scrub that I've really been loving recently is this SkinCeuticals Micro Exfoliating Scrub. Mild exfoliating gel with biomedic micro bead technology for combination or oily skin. So I actually went to go visit L'Oreal when I was in New York a few months ago, and I got all kinds of skin goodies, and I've been using pretty much all of them, a little bit obsessed. Now don't be like me and use too much of this, because I think I'm used to scrubs that are a little less concentrated. And so the first time I used this, I used way too much. I was overwhelmed. You only have to use a very small amount and mix it with water, and it will go a very long way, which is very exciting. I've said very so many times at this point. I also should mention that in the morning and at nighttime, and sometimes I miss those and I try really hard, eye cream. Eye cream is one of the things that I slept on for a long time. I don't always quite know how I'm supposed to feel with an eye cream. I don't know if it's supposed to be super light, if it's supposed to be thicker, but I've really been loving this SkinCeuticals Age Eye Complex. Again, another thing that I got to try out when I was at L'Oreal. So this is really to help with dark circles and puffiness. I've had this for months and I probably still have half of a container left. I don't have a lot of fine lines around my eyes because I try not to smile with my eyes. You know, you will feel my joy with my words. But this definitely feels refreshing and it's just become part of my skin routine. So far so good. And finally, the last part, the nighttime part of my routine, is after I do all those steps, again, cleansing, putting on a serum. I love an overnight mask, and I have several favorites, but one of my favorites and the one that I've been using the most recently has been Origins Drink Up Intensive Overnight Mask. I just got a refill of this. This is how the old packaging looked, and I kind of love the old packaging, I won't lie. But this is pretty too, Origins. I mean, I see you, you're out here. We got some little burn through designs. I'm into it. But I was confused when I showed up and I expected the green. It's fine. But you can see that I love this product. Like, this is, I'm squeezing and praying over it and just trying to get the last drop because it's so good. You don't need a lot of this. Everyone describes amounts with like a quarter size or the size of a dime. No, I put like a little blueberry amount, like a little baby blueberry amount on my fingers, mix that on both sides, got the face. I usually have enough to put on the neck. Now, when I wake up the next morning, I swear to God, and Instagram stories can tell you that it's the truth, my skin feels so glowy and radiant and bouncy, and it's just like, it just feels so good. And when I wake up and my skin feels like that, I don't even think about makeup for the day because I can feel it. I just feel connected to the universe and the stars and shit. I love this so much, I bought the travel size to take with me. Now, those are my products, like, perfect day. I'm at home, I'm in the comfort of my life. And for some reason, that combination of things does really well for my skin. However, I do wanna give a few special shout outs to a few products that, you know, as obviously I've gotten to the bottom of some of these, I have been incorporating and I've really been loving too. So they may make it onto the next list of skincare routine. This Adelia serum from Vichy, this clearly, I love it because it's half gone. One pump and it's just like your entire face and your entire neck after you cleanse. It feels so good and cooling and just, there's something about serums, and I was not into serums when I was younger, but as I've gotten older, there's just something so luxurious about them. It's like an extra step that I didn't know about, and now I know about it and I can't go back. Also, this packaging is bomb. I love it so much. And then finally, special shout out to two different cleansers that I've been using because my Glow Tonic is gone and I'm sitting here trying to figure out if I want to invest in that big bottle from Pixi. Like, I might have to invest in the big bottle, but it's, you know, it's just, I gotta make room in my life for it. I've really been enjoying Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cleanser. This is something that I feel like I've gotten a million different sample sizes of and never really was into it, but I've been liking it lately. It's kind of just a solid, good cleanser, and I'm already kind of obsessed with other Kiehl's products, so it fits well with those. And then finally, the Pixie Skin Treats Glow Mud Cleanser. This is glycolic acid and aloe vera. It's a deep purifying cleanser, almost like a little mud mask it feels like, but you rub it in for 30 seconds. I was at the Pixie store at Abbot Kinney and I saw this and I feel like I've seen other beauty people talk about it. And so I was like, let's jump in and try it. And I've really been enjoying it. Also, weirdly enough, when skincare tells you that you have to rub it in for a certain amount of time, for some reason that becomes like your meditation time. Like I walk around talking to my roommate, figuring out my life. I'm just sitting there exfoliating my face. No, it's gonna feel so good once I rinse it off. Ooh, and I'm gonna add that overnight mask. Ooh. So I hope that answers some of your questions about what I'm using on my skin, why it looks the way it does. I mean, listen, at the end of the day, products are going to only do so much. It really does come down to a lot of other factors with your life, with your genetics. But if you can find products that work together and make your skin feel good and feel its best and you feel like you look your best, it can be a fun process to figure that out. Do I know that all of these products are gonna work for you and you're gonna have the same reaction? No, because no two people have the exact same skin combo. Things that work on me really well, you might hate. That's been the case in the past. And things that I haven't really loved probably work incredibly on you. Now, because I can't shut up about skincare and I just love trying things, I love putting things on my face. Take that out of context as you want. I do wanna make a video with you guys talking about budget skincare because I know that once you start adding all these products up, it can get a little pricey. And there are definitely some shortcuts and DIY and little life hacks that you can do to get really good skincare from really minimal products. I also wanna do a video about travel skincare because the products that I take with me when I'm traveling and depending on where I'm traveling to, definitely change. So let me know below in the comments if you wanna see more videos like this, if you're interested in me making the travel and the budget skincare videos. I know it's been a while on this channel and I apologize, but I have made a pledge to myself that I really wanna be running Tanjus, Megan Tanjus, and Life Size Beauty this year, all on my own, shooting, writing, directing myself, which is a full-time job, editing, doing all of this fun stuff. And so it's just a matter of figuring out my schedule in my life. Keep your eyes open for a self-care Sunday video going up on, you guessed it, Sunday. If you want to watch other videos I've done on this channel, you can definitely go check them out, subscribe to the channel. And if you just want more me, I have a few other channels. If you like music, I've just started transitioning and moving all my music stuff over to Megan Tanjus. I play acoustic guitar and sing and do all kinds of fun stuff. And I'm working on an EP that's gonna get released this year. So you're gonna start seeing Request Tuesday covers and snippets of the EP. I have Tanjus, which is where I make daily content, a lot of news, pop culture, trends throughout the week. I have a show called People Keep Talking. I also have a series called What the Sweet Fuck. And I like to talk a lot about body positivity and why you're all badass BBs and you should run the world. If you wanna see me be snarky and weird, I highly recommend following my Twitter. If you wanna see butt photos and body positivity, I highly recommend following my Instagram. And if you wanna feel and cry and think, follow my Facebook page. I share videos every day. There's a lot of places to touch me and I'm there to be touched. Consensually and at my own discretion. Thank you. I hope that you beautiful BBs keep being beautiful and I will see you on Sunday. Bye.